What are all those people doing here?
I think it's some kind of drama presentation. Maybe it's an extension. And what was that performance all about?
Oh no.
What?
Oh no.
What?
Senior show?
What?
Senior show?
Just smile and we'll introduce the first act.
The first act already happened, remember?
Lullaby in Birdland?
Yeah.
Corinne Billings and Michelle Smith?
Yep.
Oh boy.
We're sorry, ladies and gentlemen, we're a little late.
We're just a little bit unprepared.
We'd like to welcome you all
to the 7th annual senior show.
My name is Christy Edwards.
And I'm Ciara Hunt.
We'll be your MCs for the night.
Now you will see the faculty getting funky.
It's not the line.
Well, it's a lot catchier. Anyways, now you will see the faculty getting funky with a rhyme in time saves... How many?
Nine.
Okay, with a rhyme in time saves nine. And then Alyssa Morris will follow with her beautiful rendition of Winter.
Ciara, Corinne Billings is singing Winter. Alyssa Morris is singing Summertime.
That's what I said.
Aren't you forgetting something?
I don't think so.
You'll also see the Argument Clinic performed by Niall Klein, Owen Moore,
Emma Miles, and Alex Tishman.
We hope you enjoy the show.
But before we go, I'd like to give one of my motivational speeches. I'd like to talk about believing in yourself and loving others.
Isn't it an assembly, remember?
Anyways, we hope you enjoy the show.
And when I sell milk, I'm not always paid.
Oh,
Queen Josephine, Queen Josephine, this woman was helping us. She was giving her hints behind her back. She must have witnessed that others laugh.
Who are you, anyway? Out now before I have someone carry you away.
My name is Lenora, a teller of tales. Some say I sing as sweetly as nightingales. I'll tell you a story of a far-off land, Timbuktu, Mindao, or even Samarkand. That's all very well, but you're off track. What's this about giving clues behind my back? A thousand pardons for my foolish action, but the words were their own and were met with satisfaction.
That's true enough, lucky for you. But see that it doesn't happen again, because the next time it does, you're through.
What will we do? Shall throw us all in jail. Oh, thank you for saving us, Lenora. But what about the fish merchant?
There must be a way to get our friend out of jail.
There must be a way to change a queen's mind if we just think hard enough.
We have to think of something. I've got it!
No, that won't do. Maybe if we...
No, that won't do either.
How can you sit there so calmly?
I am thinking. While all of you are pacing around, Maureen, I am thinking. It's easier to think when you're calm.
Where are you going?
I'm moving to another country. Goodbye.
Goodbye. I hope you get through the roadblocks.
Roadblocks?
Yes, the Queen has closed all the roads leading out of Noma.
What shall I do?
Help us think of a way to change the Queen's mind.
How can I do that? All I know how to do is sell spices.
Hear ye, hear ye. Queen Josephine hereby decrees that she is the cleverest rhyme maker around and challenges anyone and everyone to stand his or her ground and enter contest with the Queen, whose name we know is Josephine.
That's it. Harold, what will be the prize for the winner of the contest?
The winner shall receive what his or her heart desires. If the challenger loses, then his or her life expires.
Friend, that's the answer. Why the contest, of course.
Of course. Lenora, you can be Queen Josephine riding any day.
That's right, Lenora. We'll be there to cheer you on.
Let the contest begin, and may Her Highness win.
There once was a man from Rangoon who sang by the light of the moon. Each night he went out and gave a great shout. Finish the limerick, if you can.
There once was a man from Rangoon who sang by the light of the moon. Each night he went out and gave a great shout because he was, forsooth, a baboon. All right, my turn to challenge. There once was a girl from France who decided to learn how to dance. She danced with her brothers, then watched all the others. Finish that, Your Majesty, if you can. There once was a girl from France who decided to learn how to dance. She danced with her brothers, then watched all the others because no one would give her a chance. All right, you silly teller of tales. If you don't rhyme this one, you'll go to jail. Poet, make a rhyme about what I have in my hand. Why, 'tis nothing but a coin of gold. From the date I can tell 'tis very old. 'Tis too heavy to float and too stiff to fold. It is exchanged when something is sold. And thus the tale of this coin is told. Your Majesty, great Queen Josephine, if I should win this contest, will you grant me one wish?
Yes, yes, if you win, but you're wasting time. Begin again.
Make a rhyme about what I hold in my hand, and Your Majesty shall surely be the greatest rhyme maker in the land.
Well, well, let me see. 'Tis nothing but a coin of silver. From its shine, I see that. I see that. What rhymes with silver?
Silver! Silver!
There's no such word! I have it, Your Majesty. Silver! You know, with cold out, so cold outside, the man was shivering all over. That's shivering, you simpleton! There's no such word as shivering!
Silver, 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 silver.
Nothing rhymes with silver. All right, minstrel, you win. You get your wish.
Thank you, Your Majesty. My wish is that you free the prisoner from the tower within the hour and admit how absurd it is to rhyme with every word. Your wish is granted. No one has to rhyme anymore.
Free the prisoner!
Oh, thank you, Your Highness, for setting me free!
Don't mention it. Oh, don't worry, Your Highness. After all, it's more important to be loved by your subjects than to make rhymes.
Hooray for Lenora! Hooray for good Queen Josephine!
Yes, I couldn't agree with you more. But there's just one thing.
What is it?
I still wish I could think of a word that rhymes with silver.
Yes, it is. nonsense.
Oh, this is futile.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. Look, I came here for a good argument.
Ah, no, you didn't. You just came here for an argument. Any argument at all, and not necessarily a good one.
Yes, I know, but argument can't just be contradiction.
Well, it can be.
No, it can't.
Yeah?
No, argument is a connected series of statements intended to establish a proposition.
It isn't.
Yes, it is. It isn't just contradiction.
Well, look, if I argue with you, I must take up a contraposition.
Yes, I know. But it isn't just saying, no, it isn't.
Isn't it?
No, it isn't. Argument, intellectual process. Contradiction is just an automatic gainsaying of anything that a person has to say.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
It is.
It is.
It is.
Thank you, that's it.
But I was just getting interested.
I'm sorry, the 5 minutes is up.
That wasn't 5 minutes.
I'm afraid it was.
5 cents.
Look, I'm not allowed to argue anymore unless you pay.
Oh. This is ridiculous.
Yes. Well, you know, I've told you, if you want me to go out arguing, you can just have to pay for the 5 minutes.
But that was never 5 minutes just now.
I'm afraid it was.
All right.
Thank you.
Well?
Well, what?
Well, aren't you going to argue? I just paid.
No, you haven't.
I have. Wait a second. If you're arguing, I must have paid. Ha! I've got you.
No, you haven't.
You haven't? I have.
You haven't?
I have.
You know, I could be arguing in my spare time.
I've had enough of this.
No, you haven't.
What do you know? I told you it was the senior show. I never said it wasn't. Don't act like a kid. Yes, you did. No, I didn't. I suppose you're going to say I don't know the next act is either. Don't be so cross. No, I am not. Stop rhyming. You're driving me crazy. Oh, announce the next act. Don't be so lazy. Fine, I will. The next act is a sensational ballet solo performed by the dazzling Lauren Anabuski. I bet you didn't know she's been dancing for 7 years. Whatever, she thinks she's so clever. Then you will be swept away at the sounds of Kristen Raymond singing Yesterday with Alex Tishman accompanying on guitar. You swine, that was my line.
I had to cut off your rhyme.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Fine, I'll let it go this time. Well, we all have our faults. So tell me, Chris, do you know how to waltz?
No. Why?
Because one of the next acts is called the Waltz of the Toreadors.
Of the what?
Of the Toreadors. Don't ask me.
I don't think they actually do the waltz in that act. Seen from a play?
Well, so much for learning how to waltz.
Anyhow, the characters in the scene are Emily and Leon St. Pay.
And they are played by the artistic Corinne Billings and Patrick Sorensen.
Enjoy.
The fun has just begun.
Thank you. You may go. I am sleepy. Oh, no, madame, you are not asleep. That would be too easy. Open your eyes. Open your eyes this instant. Do as I tell you, Emily. Ah, what new game are you playing now?
My heart!
What about your heart?
It's shrinking! My Leon, I never loved anyone else but you!
Oh no, not your heart. We haven't even raised our voices yet. Your heart attack is for after the big scenes, madame. You are warm, your pulse is good. I'm not falling for that. Wake up, Emily. You can't be as rigid as that. You're doing it on purpose. I'll get your drops. Holy Moses, what a collection. It'll take a qualified druggist to make head or tail of this lot. There's enough here to upset the constitution of a card horse. Needless to say, no dropper. Where the devil did Eugenie put the thing? Oh well, here goes. One drop more, one drop less. The way things are now. Here, Emily, drink this. And if that doesn't do the trick, I'll call the doctor. Unclench your teeth, my love. Unclench your teeth! Damn you, it's dripping all over. Give me strength. What's the matter with you? I'll give you your injection.
You're still rummaging, Leon. You're suspicious of me even on my deathbed.
I'm not rummaging. I'm looking for your capsule.
Too late. Call the children.
What are you raving about? You aren't dying. You're weak, that's all. I'll get the doctor.
Too late. I implore you, Leon. Don't move. Stay with me as you did in the old days when I was ill. You took care of me then. You were patient with me then. You used to bathe my temple with eau de cologne and murmur sweet nothings in my ear.
I can still dab you with a bit of cologne.
But without the sweet nothings? It's that that's killing me! You murderer!
She drives me up the wall. Well, I guess I'm going to have to use a little bit of my magic power and make her appear. Would you like that?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm going to have to meditate a bit to stir up my power. Voila! I did it! What did you do now? I made you appear. Silly girl!
No, you just interrupted my dance recital.
Oh, well, I'm such a good magician.
Whatever you say, Ciara. Don't we have one more performance before intermission?
Oh, yes. Be prepared to see handkerchiefs appear, eggs disappear, and have your minds read in the mind-boggling magic act by the sweet, the saucy, the stupendous Chanteron Jones!
Show everyone a few tricks. But before I do these, let's hear it again for the MC, Sir Greg Archer!
Yeah!
Alright, here's my first trick. I have this yellow scarf here. What do you think I should do with it? Stick it up my nose? No, I have a better idea. How about I make it disappear? And in order for me to do that, I need a can of invisible paint. There's some paint right here. I'm going to take the paint and dump it inside of my hand. And then I'm going to take the paint can and throw it away into the invisible garbage can because everyone knows that it's very bad to litter, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to now take this scarf and proceed to dip it inside of the invisible paint. The scarf goes inside of the invisible paint, and now what we need are a few magical words. And the magical words that we'll be using throughout the show are senior show. Can everyone please say that?
Senior show.
With those magical words, the scarf will actually vanish. No, look at the scarf gone. Why doesn't everyone check their pockets? Anything in their pockets? Nothing in your pockets? Well, I got another idea. Could you please take off your shoe? I think there's something in there. Do you see anything in there? Is there anything in there?
No.
Let me see it, please. Thank you very much. I think there's something in there. There's a bunch of lint in here, I think. Well, you know what? There's nothing in here because we haven't said the magical words yet. Would everyone please say the magical words once again, which were what?
Senior show.
And with those magical words, I think you'll find a scarf in there. everyone, I'm about to show the invisible deck to you guys today. This is the invisible deck. But first of all, does everyone believe in magic?
Yeah!
That wasn't good. Does everyone believe in magic?
Yeah!
All right, this is the invisible deck, okay? This is a visible deck right here, as you can see. But this is the invisible deck, it going inside of my pocket. That was a trick, right? No, that wasn't the trick. I'm going to take this ball of yarn, and I'm going to throw it into the audience to get a random spectator. Would somebody grab that and come up here, please? Give them a round of applause! What is your name?
My name is Marvin.
Would everyone please give Marvin another round of applause? The amazing invisible deck. Are you ready? Are you pumped, really?
I'm ready.
Alright, check this out. I'm gonna reach inside of my pocket and pull out an invisible deck of cards. Can everyone see this deck of cards?
No.
No, because it's invisible, right? Can you see this deck of cards? You can't see it because it's invisible, right? Could you please take this deck out of my hands, take it out? And why don't you open up the deck and take out the cards, please? Open up the back pantomime and take out the cards, and then shuffle them right here on my hands. He's an excellent shuffler, isn't he? Can you please take a card out of this deck now? Choose wisely. Look at that card, and think of a card inside of your mind. Nothing common like the Ace of Spades, okay? Think of a total off-the-wall card. Okay? Show that card to the audience. Okay, what I'm going to now do is take these invisible cards and place them face up on my arm. Can you see the face up cards on my arm? Can any of you guys?
No.
Because they're invisible, right? You see they're invisible. You see a card? I'm going to take your card and put it face down inside of this face up deck. So there's one face down card inside of the deck, okay? I'm going to gather up all the cards. Marvin, I need the cards for the pack then. Or the pack for the cards back. The other way around. Thank you very much. You stole them? Okay, check this out. I'm going to place all the invisible cards back inside the pack, close up the pack. And now, Marvin, what I'm going to try to do is make fantasy become reality, okay? I'm going to take this invisible pack and place it inside of the visible pack. What do you know? A card trick, right? Okay, Marvin, could I please know the name of the card that you chose inside of your mind?
Yeah, the four hearts.
Thank you very much, Marvin. You may sit down. Thank you very much. Get up. He says the four of hearts. You know what? Inside of this deck, I actually turned over one card. One card face down. And it is going to be the four of hearts, believe it or not. Let's look inside this deck, okay? Inside this deck, there should be one face down card. Can everyone see that blue back in there? Okay, and the one face down card. And it's going to be, let's hope, the Four of Hearts. Everyone, get prepared to get your minds read. In order for this to happen, I need everyone to think of a number between 2 and 10 inside of their minds. Can everyone do that? I hope you can. If I can, you can, right? Everyone think of a number between 2 and 10 inside of their minds. Now everyone has a number. Multiply that number by 9. I hope all of you can do math, right? If I can do math, you can do math. Multiply that number by 9 inside of your minds. Now, I said I was going to read your minds, right? Everyone think of a 2-digit number, right? Right? That's my idea. No, I was joking.
Take that two-digit number, though, and add the two digits together. So if your number was 31, for instance, you take 3 plus 1 and get 4. But none of you will have that number, I hope. But take the two-digit number and add the two digits together. So now everyone has yet another number, correct?
Yes.
Okay, take 5 away from that number now. Has everyone done that?
Yeah.
Okay, take 5 away from that number. Now correspond that new number to a letter of the alphabet. So if your number was 1, the letter would be A. If it was 2, it would be B, and so forth. So now everyone is thinking of a letter now, correct? Now correspond that letter to a country. Think of a country that begins with that letter, okay? Everyone think of a country that begins with that letter, okay? Now take the second letter of that country and think of a large animal, okay? Now everyone's thinking of a large animal. Now take the color of that animal and think of it. Now think of the country, the color of the animal, and the animal itself, and keep it in your minds. I'm about to read everyone's mind here tonight. You know what? There are no great elephants in Denmark. Dump it inside of the cup. Now this is how a magician drinks his water. All he has to do go, and the water will actually vanish. Thank you very much. Would everyone like to learn a trick?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay, what I'm going to do is take this yellow scarf and dip it inside of my hand. Kind of like the first trick where the scarf was going inside of the invisible paint. See if you can get the scarf all the way in my hand. Except this time, the scarf is not going to vanish. It is going to actually turn into, voila, an egg, right? It turns into an egg. Now, would everyone like to know how this trick was accomplished?
Yeah.
Okay, all I had to do was take a decoy egg, a fake plastic egg, and drill a hole into it. Does everyone see that? So all I had to do was take a fake plastic egg, drill a hole into it, conceal the egg inside of my hand, take the scarf, proceed to dip the scarf into the egg, actually my hand, into the egg, and then there was a fake plastic egg, right? You know what? I just gave away a classic in magic. And no magician should reveal a secret, right? It's not a real illusion. So what I'm going to attempt to do is show everyone a real illusion. I'm going to take the silk scarf back out of the egg and prove to all of you that I was never actually using a fake egg, that I was always, in fact, using a real egg. Thank you very much. I have one more trick to show. Ciara Hunt, would you please be my lovely assistant tonight? Oh. Give her a round of applause. Ciara, are you ready to take part in this trick?
Oh, yes.
Are all of you ready to take part in this trick?
Yeah.
I have a regular deck of cards here, okay? Ciara, would you please... Yeah, you can't really see him. You don't know if it's a regular deck or not, right? Would you please stick your finger in there anyway? We're going to cut the cards right at that point, and Ciara, take this top card off and show it to the audience, please. Can everyone see that card? It's not an invisible card, so most of you can be able to see it, right? Can everyone see that card?
Yeah.
Okay. Ciara, would you please put it on top of this deck? So everyone saw the card. I'm going to now cut the deck and lose your card in the deck, okay, Ciara?
Okay.
I'm going to take two cards out of this deck, which I think could be your card, okay? This card could be your card, or this card could be your card. Everyone's got to give me two chances at least, okay? Here's the first chance, right? This has got to be your card, right? Was your card the Queen of Hearts?
No.
chance?
Seriously?
Okay. I know what you were thinking of what the card was. It was a club, right?
A club?
It was the Eight of Clubs, right?
No.
Okay, everyone, we have to make a little bit of magic happen here tonight. Why doesn't everyone make a big impression of the card inside of their mind? All right, can everyone do that? A big impression of the card inside of their mind. Was your card the Ace of Clubs? Well, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
already more than I can say. My first impressions of people are never wrong.
How nice of you to like me so much after we have known each other such a comparatively short time. Pray sit down.
I may call you Cecily, may I not?
With pleasure.
And you will always call me Gwendolyn, won't you?
If you wish.
And it's all quite settled, is it not?
I hope so.
Perhaps this might be a favorable opportunity for my mentioning who I am. My father is Lord Bracknell. You have never heard of Papa, I suppose.
I don't think so.
Papa outside the family circle is entirely unknown. I think that is quite how it should be. You are here on a short visit, I suppose.
I think kindly. Pray do. I think that whenever anyone has anything unpleasant to say, one should always be quite candid.
Well, perfect candor, Cecily. I wish you were full 42, and more than usually plain for your age. Ernest has a strong, upright nature. He has the very soul of truth and honor. His loyalty would be impossible to human perception. But even men of the noblest possible moral character...
I beg your pardon, Gwendolyn, but did you say Ernest?
Yes.
But it is not Mr. Ernest Worthing who is my guardian.
It is his brother.
His elder brother.
Ernest never mentioned to me had a brother.
I'm sorry to say that they have not been on good terms for quite a long time.
Well, that accounts for it. Come to think of it, I've never heard any man mention.
Dearest Gwendolyn, don't you know, right? There's no reason why I should make it up a secret to you. Our little county newspaper should chronicle the fact next week. Mr. Ernest Worthing and I are engaged to be married.
I am afraid there must be some slight error. Mr. Ernest Worthing is engaged to me. The announcement will appear in the Morning Post Saturday at the latest.
I am afraid you must be under some misconception. Ernest proposed to me exactly 10 minutes ago.
It is certainly very curious, for he asked me to be his wife yesterday at 5:30. I'm sorry if it is any disappointment to you, dear Cecily, but I'm afraid I have the prior claim. The poor boy has been attracted to any foolish entanglement. I shall consider it my duty to rescue him with firm hand.
Do you suggest, Miss Fairfax, that I entrapped Ernest into an entanglement? How dare you! This is no time for wearing the shallow mask of manners!
Are there many interesting walks in the vicinity, Miss Cardew?
Oh, yes, a great many. From the top of one of the hills quite close, one can see 5 counties!
5 counties! You detestable girl, but I require tea.
Sugar?
No, thank you. Sugar isn't fashionable anymore.
Cake? Or bread and butter?
Bread and butter, please. Cake is rarely seen in the best houses nowadays.
No, dear girl, say it
like this.
Chaya, Chaya. You know, like chai, the tea.
Oh, right.
Chaya, Chaya. Oh, you got it, I suppose.
Thank goodness. It means shadow, doesn't it, Ms. Edwards?
It does, Ms. Hunt. On another note, has your beau ever asked you to go skiing with him before?
No.
Why? Mine has, but don't worry, darling, because after he hears the apology performed by Katie Music, he'll be afraid not to ask you to go with him. Well, let's not forget the
she'll also be seen a performance by a group of talented young gentlemen that I happen to have tickets to go see.
Oh, really?
Yes. And they are said to be a combination between Boys to Men, the Beastie Boys, and Eminem's.
Eminem's?
Yes, you know that song. Hello, my name is. Hello, my name is. Hello, my name is.
I never seem to know what you're talking about.
Oh, just watch and you will.
Fine.
Oh.
Thank you.
my boyfriend went on a skiing trip. Not that I like skiing, because in all honesty, I don't. It's not the point. The point is, he did not invite me. And I got really angry. Well, I'm over that now, and I am ready to apologize. I didn't. I'm not very good with words, so I did it in the form of a poem that I wrote myself. I didn't mean it when I said, I hope the cable in the elevator snaps when you step on board. I was joking when I said, I hope you crack your head and get mangled by the downstairs revolving doors. I was kidding when I said, I hope the number 103 bus makes a pancake out of you. I'm sorry. Forgive me. It's amazing what a woman in love will do. I really don't want to see your taxi on the 59th Street Bridge flip over and crash through the rail. And I feel bad if, well, at the airport, carries you away from me. And I'm sorry that I said, I hope you break both legs on the mountain while you ski. And I'm sorry for all of those nasty things I said about your mother, even though we both know they're true. I'm sorry, forgive me for all of those mean things I said to you. Sniffing dogs. A simple little nipping would suffice. And most of all, I don't want to get radiation poisoning from the metal detector that all passengers and foreign and domestic flights must walk through. I'm sorry. But I am still mad at you.
Oh!
Beastie Boys, Eminem.
And maybe Metallica.
All rolled into one.
You got it, girl!
Now we have Hua.
Hua?
Hua Hone.
Oh man, that must be that Tiana Steinbeck chick's Hawaiian dance. After you see Tiana, Megan Bates will knock your boots off
with her strong voice
and spicy song,
yodeling blues.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
crack.
Wow, that was like incredible.
Yeehaw.
You know that singer Jewel can yodel, but that vegan bass can yodel.
I bet that Britney Spears girl can't yodel.
Well, I'll have to agree with you there, cowgirl. Anyhow, it's just about time to say farewell to y'all.
But first, we have one more talented dance routine to every girl's nightmare and every boy's dream.
Britney Spears?
Like, how do you know? You know, partner, your shoes kind of remind me of the shoes that Britney Spears would wear.
Really?
You know, the guys have been all over me since I bought them. Really? Is Britney Spears really 23? Well, I heard it on MTV, and everything you hear on MTV is true.
You know, partner, do you think, like, that Britney girl is in an abusive relationship?
Why would you say that?
Duh, like the chorus of her big song is Hit Me Baby One More Time.
You are great.
Whatever. Now it's time to introduce our final act, Spearmint.
Like the gown?
Whatever you say, Ciara.
Featuring Harry Simpson and Ira Gray
as two fresh party boys.
And introducing Alyssa Morris,
Anna Samuel,
Aaron Duffy,
Holly Howe,
Karis Tristan,
Nicole Kamada,
Rebecca Wheelan,
and Tibby Gerzik-Blum.
Which one is Britney Spears again?
All of them, except me!
She'll be all right. At this experiment, we please be seated for the grand finale.
Oh man, Harry, Britney Spears is so hot!
No, she's so hot! Katie.
You're hot! Britney Spears is hot!
We've been good kids. We've been eating our vegetables. And we haven't been listening to the rap music too much. So we have one wish. Just one wish.
Please make every girl Britney Spears!
I'm sorry.
Thank you.